Praise the Lord. Everybody praise the Lord.
Oh,
this
yeah.
is the day the Lord has made.
And we shall rejoice.
We're going to rejoice. And be glad
in it. Because God has supplied all of our needs.
Yes.
According to his riches in glory. You know, the Lord is our light and our salvation. Whom shall we fear? The Lord is the strength of our lives. Mm-hmm. Of whom shall we be afraid? When the wicked, even our enemy, our foe, came upon us to eat up our flesh, they stumbled and they fell. Though an host should encamp against us, our hearts shall not fear. Though war should rise against us, in this we will be confident.
Yes.
Because there is only one thing we desire and we seek after. We just want to dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of our lives to see the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple.
Thank you,
you know, he or she that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is our refuge, our fortress, our God. In him we can trust. His shield is our truth and our buckler. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. Thou shalt not be afraid of the terror by night, nor the arrow that flieth by day, nor the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor the destruction that wasteth at noonday. For 1,000 shall fall at our side.
Yes.
10,000 has fallen at our right hand. But it shall not, or it did not, come nigh us.
Okay.
Only with our eyes shall we behold and see the reward of the wicked, because we've made the Lord God, even the Most High God, our habitation. And no evil shall befall us.
Mm.
No plague.
That's a lot right there.
No plague.
No plague.
Is coming near our dwelling. For he shall give his angels charge over us to keep us in all our ways, and they're going to bear us up in their hands, lest we dashed our foot against a stone. We can tread upon the lion and adder, and the young lion and dragon will trample under our feet. And because we set our love upon him, God will deliver and honor us.
Yes, he will.
He will set us on high.
Yes, he will.
Just because we know his name.
Ooh. Know his name.
We can call upon him.
What is his name?
Jesus.
Jesus.
We can call upon the name of Jesus and he will answer.
Yes, he will.
He'll always be there. He'll answer, here I am.
Yes, he will.
God will deliver and honor us.
Yes.
And with long life,
Ooh.
He will satisfy us and show us his salvation. What a mighty God we serve.
What a mighty God we
serve. Hey, y'all come on in here. In case you don't know, you need to know. We are your host. I'm Elder Alfred L. Calvert, amen, of the Mount Calvary International Outreach. And this is the fabulous, the vivacious, the gifted, the gorgeous, the beautiful, the pretty, the Empress Vicki Lockhart Calvert.
Good morning.
Oh,
good
we're just
morning.
So good thankful.
Afternoon.
So thankful. Good
we
afternoon.
Love you.
We love you. We love you. Come on in. Hey, and let's get over together. How about
get
that?
Over. Let's get over. Amen. Amen.
Yeah, let's go on over together. We do it better
together.
Come on in.
Amen. Amen. I see California's in.
Oh, man. My best
city
friend.
City of Compton.
Straight out of Compton. Had the city of Compton. George McDaniel. My best friend, Skeeter J.
Ooh,
Jones, is in the house.
We love you. And Val
we
Ringo.
We love you, Val Ringo. Our first responders. We love you so much. Skeeter sent his tithe, I think, last night.
Mm-hmm.
He paid his tithe last night.
We heard a little ding.
Ding. I had to get up and...
We had to make sure it wasn't an emergency.
Yeah.
But it was an urgency.
An urgency.
From Compton.
Yeah, straight out
California.
Of Compton. Yeah, and then Deacon Price sent his offering in early this morning. So we're so thankful for you who believe in this ministry enough to share your finances with this ministry, because only... what you do for Christ
Amen.
Shall last. And
Amen.
When you give,
mm-hmm.
God will give back to you good measure, pressed down,
shaken
together,
and
running over.
Woo!
He'll help somebody to give to your bosom.
Amen.
And it might not be monetary. It could be good health.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Come on.
How did he do it? He can do it.
Hey, I'll accept it.
Amen. Amelia, we thank you. We love you,
we love
girl.
You.
We see you and coming in. Artie Hudson is also watching.
Oh my God, the fashionistas. The fashionistas.
Yes, we love you guys.
Are in the house.
God bless you.
God bless you.
Well, it's time for reread.
Yeah, we're going to have a good time today. So stick and stay. Don't go away, because today we got a word from the Lord. Come on, y'all. Come on. Come on. Let's go. Jesus. Ooh, when I think about the goodness of the Lord.
Ooh. I look back over my life.
Over my life and think things over. I just have to shout, Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Woo. We're so thankful to have all of you to join in with us today.
Yes,
hallelujah.
Lord.
Before we go to some joy, unspeakable joy, Woo. I just want to thank God for you all over this world. Mm-hmm. We don't take it for granted, hallelujah, that you don't need the Lord. We know you need the Lord because he is the light of the world. So if you're in Liberia,
Amen.
We want to thank God with you.
Thank
Apuzzo.
You.
If you're in France, merci bonjour. Excuse moi, s'il vous plaît.
Yes.
Merci bonjour. In Ethiopia, ex habia, ex estelin. If you're in Portugal, obrigado Deus. If you're in Germany, we thank God with you, danke God.
Mm.
Out there among the Hmong people, Ocho Yesu. In Vietnam, Kamang Yesu.
Yes.
If you're in Russia, spasiba, Borgu Pashao. If you're in the Philippines, Salamat Jesus. If you're in India, Haidi If you're in Jerusalem, our Hebrew brothers and sisters,
mm-hmm.
Baruch Tashan Adonai.
Yes.
In Moroccan, Alhamdulillah, Assalamu Alaikum. If you're in Korea, Kamsa Hamida. In China, Shishi Shin. If you're in Nigeria, Ikele De Chuku. In Sudan, Tina Te Lo Yesu Christo. If you're in West Nigeria, Adupe Lodo Olorun. If you're in Luganda, Wibale Yesu. In Sierra Leone, Papa God 10K. If you're in Gambia, Abaraka. If you're Chaldean, Shakru Alaha. We thank God with you in Jordan where Jesus got baptized. Amen. Shukran Alaha. If you're in Iran, Nisko Allah. If you're a Muslim, and we thank God for all of our Muslim brothers and sisters,
yes.
Dora Muhammad, amen, Dawood Abdul Rahman, on behalf of his lovely, beautiful wife, Khadija, who passed away, amen, we say, and Richard Ford, can't forget my good friend, Richard Ford,
yes.
Assalamu alaikum, du Allah. If you're Spanish, amen, como estas? Bien, usted, amen, como se llama? Amen, Alfredo, Vicky, amen, Benito, dear.
Muy bien, y tú.
Alabado el nombre del Señor. Amen. And if you're over in Japan, I wish I could take my wife to the beautiful places I've been to over there, like Yokosuka, Sasebo, Yokohama, Tokyo. But since we're not there, we still can thank God with you and say, arigato gozaimasu.
Yeah.
But if we couldn't say nothing, if our tongue was cleaved to the roof of our mouth, we would just want you to know that God bless your basket,
yes.
bless your store,
yes.
bless your going out, your
yes.
coming in, your down sitting, and your uprising. Hallelujah, that God would just bless your lives. Amen. And whatever betides, that God will take care of you. And also, my good friend, amen, Samuel Wilson, who lost his wife, Lady J. Wilson. We are mourning with you, we're weeping with you, our hearts are filling you, amen. Bishop Samuel Wilson, who lost his wife this week, Lady J. Wilson, and all of those, the helpless, the homeless, the sick and the afflicted, the orphan, the bereaved everywhere, and the refugee, God bless you. We're thanking God for Big 50, amen, as you travel, amen. This week, we're praying traveling mercies upon your life. Big 50, Deronda,
yes.
amen, Deronda,
yes.
Big 50, we had a great time with you, eulogizing your loved one. We had a great time with you this week, so we thank God for her also and her family.
Yes.
I want to let you know also that whatever betide, God will take care of you. He's the God of all comfort and the Father of all mercy. So let's just praise him right
yes,
now
yes.
and give him thanks for this great
also
day.
To our Pakistan family.
Our Pakistan family, God bless you. Sheba in Pakistan.
Hallelujah.
Our church in Pakistan, we love you. We haven't forgotten about you.
God will take care
of you. God will take care of you with that property you're trying to buy to build the church. We will contribute to that. So God bless you in Jesus'
yes.
mighty name.
Let's
Hallelujah.
Worship.
Let's worship him. Come on, y'all. Come on, y'all. Come on, come on, come on. Come on in, y'all. Let's bless his name. Bless his name. Oh, hallelujah. Come on, bless his name.
Send
the praises up. When the praises go up, the blessings come down. When the praises go up, the blessings come down. come down in Jesus' mighty name.
Yes. Wave your hand out there. Yes. Lift up some hearts.
What I do.
Lift up some hearts.
Come on, y'all. Come on, come on, come on. Come on, bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Let us exalt his name together. Oh, magnify the Lord with us. Oh, somebody bless his name. Oh, yes. Hallelujah. It's what I do. Come on, William. Come on, William. Lift him up. What we do.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Unspeakable joy is what we have this morning. That's why we praise the Lord. Yes. I will bless the Lord at all times,
time.
Whether good or bad or happy or sad,
yes.
I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praises shall continually be in my mouth. That is the fruit of our lips,
yes,
giving
Lord.
Thanks
Thank you,
to his name. Continually.
Continually,
because
yes,
that is
Lord.
Our help, that is our hope, mm-hmm. hallelujah, in the resurrection and the life. Amen.
Hallelujah.
So you got some joy, unspeakable joy?
We sure do.
Well, stay with it then.
We got joy, unspeakable joy. That's what we got.
That's what we got.
Amen.
We got some joy, unspeakable joy that we're going to pray for everybody out there today. Hey, if you're having something that's ailing you in your body, we're going to get rid of it today.
Mm-hmm.
Not tomorrow, today.
Yeah, today.
Now faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. First, you got to believe that he is God and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. And your reward today, that whatever is troubling you in your body, it has to decease and desist. It has to be abrogated, alleviated today. So stick and stay. Don't go away.
So
we got a prayer and a word from the Lord. But right now, let's party. Amen. With Douglas Miller and joy unspeakable. Joy.
Come on, y'all.
My soul.
Come on.
So overwhelmed. Oh, yes, Lord. I got joy. 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 When I think how he brought me through, how the Lord saved my life, my soul, soul is over. Oh yes, Lord, I got joy, joy unspeakable joy. Hey, joy, joy unspeakable joy. Come on in here, y'all.
Joy unspeakable, halfway right. Joy unspeakable, full of glory. Joy unspeakable, bird of light. Every time I think of the goodness of the Lord. Yeah, joy. Joy unspeakable joy. One more time. Joy unspeakable joy.
Hey!
with joy. The goodness of Jesus. Him.
I love it. I love the Lord.
And stop telling folk the devil stole your joy.
Devil
can't steal your joy.
Mm-mm.
Because he don't know where God put it. That's why it's called unspeakable joy.
Mm-hmm.
Don't you speak on the devil stealing anything from you that God put in you. The devil don't know where God put it. He can't steal it.
He don't know.
Can't steal your peace.
Mm-mm.
Your joy.
Mm-mm.
God hid it in the secret place.
Ooh.
Hallelujah of the Most High.
Ooh.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Lord bless his name today.
Yes.
Let's pray. And then we're going to have words of life.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Let's pray.
Okay.
Because we got to get some of these diseases out of folk lives today.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Folk have diabetes, getting their toes cut off and all kind of stuff. Amen.
Yes.
We just witnessed this week a gentleman died from multiple sclerosis. We got to get rid of that stuff.
Yeah. In the name of Jesus.
There is a bomb in Gilead.
Yes.
There is a bomb in Gilead. If I may but touch the hem of his garment,
amen,
I shall be made whole. So by faith,
mm-hmm.
by faith, touch somebody close to you, because you could be touching somebody that could be touching God.
Mm-mm.
And by faith, we all going to touch the hem of his garment.
Thank you, Lord.
And be made whole today. Not tomorrow.
Yes.
That stuff got to go today. Father, in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
You told us in your word, Psalms 103:3, that you forgiveth all our iniquity. And that you healeth all our diseases.
Thank you, Jesus.
So we're like that woman with the issue of blood. And we have to crawl.
Mm.
Push our wheelchair. Mm-hmm. Hop on our crutches.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever we have to do. To get to you, God. To touch the hem of your garment. We're coming to be made whole today.
Hallelujah.
Diabetes, you got to decease and desist right now in the lives of everyone that is under the sound of my voice that believe it.
Thank you, Lord.
High blood pressure, come down.
Mm-hmm.
Low blood pressure, come up. Heart attack, abrogated, alleviated.
Mm-hmm.
Those who are on dialysis, I curse it from the root.
Hallelujah.
God put blood in you. Blood clean up. Hallelujah. Because the life of the flesh is in the blood.
Hallelujah.
Clean up right
yes.
now.
Yes, Lord.
In the name, the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Cancer.
Come out.
That's right.
Come out of that breast. Come out of that liver. Come out of that bowel. Come out of that stomach right now.
Thank you, Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Mental illness.
Mm. Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus,
yes,
who thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation, but came in the form of a servant and in the likeness of a man. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And being found in fashion of a man, he humbled himself.
Mm.
Humble yourself under the mighty hand of God.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
And let good sense come into your mind.
Yes, Lord.
Let your mind be renewed right now by the word of God.
Yes, yes, Lord.
You ain't crazy.
Mm-mm.
That's just the devil running rapid through your system. Come out in the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Thank
and be
you,
covered
Lord.
With the blood of Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
Jesus
came down through 42 generations. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Mm.
Born in Bethlehem, hid in Egypt.
Mm.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Tempted in the wilderness, raised up in Nazareth, baptized
you,
in Jordan.
Healed,
performed miracles by the roadside.
Thank you, Lord.
You by the roadside now. Jesus said, you got sight.
Yes.
You once was blind, but now you see.
Mm.
In the name of Jesus. He healed multitudes with no vaccine. You're healed right now in Jesus' mighty name.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' name.
Thank you, Jesus.
He performed miracles and made no charge for his service. This don't cost you anything.
Hmm.
Because you're reaching the hem of Jesus' garment.
Yes, Lord.
And you're made whole right now.
Mm-hmm.
Healed and made whole. In Jesus' mighty name.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul.
And all that is within me.
Followed up with words of life.
Mm-hmm.
Thou speak now that they're healed, speak words of life into their system.
Yes.
Receive these words of
yes.
life. Don't miss
yes.
this. Don't miss what, don't, hey. Don't be fooled
Thank you, Lord.
By this little cute face. This is God's daughter, anointed by God. I know she's anointed. To put up with me for 13 years, there has to be a special anointing upon her. How many of you got a one-leg husband? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, I said it. How many of you would date me if I had, and I got one leg? She has a special anointing of love and power of God upon her. So don't miss these words. Repeat these words after her.
Proverbs 18 and 21, it says, death and life are in the power of the tongue.
Yes.
And they that love it,
my Lord,
shall eat the fruit thereof.
Ain't
Amen.
That right? Ain't that right?
So I want you to repeat after me. These are blessings from God. Amen.
Repeat now, repeat.
Speak life.
Speak life.
Speak life.
Speak life.
I am blessed.
I am blessed.
I am healed.
I am healed.
I am forgiving.
I am forgiving.
I am generous.
I am generous.
I am favored.
I am favored.
I am well able.
I am well able.
I am courageous.
I am courageous.
I am unstoppable.
I am unstoppable.
I am confident.
I am confident.
I am determined.
I am determined.
I am strengthened.
I am strengthened.
I am anointed.
I am anointed.
I am gifted.
I am gifted.
I am successful.
I am successful.
I am beautiful.
I am beautiful.
I am youthful and dynamic.
I'm so youthful and dynamic, I can't stand it. I'm youthful and dynamic.
I am whole.
I am whole, healed, whole.
And I am. God's masterpiece.
God's masterpiece.
He said, I was fearfully and wonderfully made.
Tell
Amen.
Yourself, I am fearfully and wonderfully made by God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Because
I can do all
things
through Christ.
Which strengthened me. Because
I am more than a conqueror.
Through him.
Through him.
That loved me.
That loved me.
He said, greater is,
greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world.
Ooh, and if God be for you.
God be for me.
Who can be against me? Lord.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Hallelujah.
Words of life. Hallelujah.
You know, when we go through the fire,
yeah,
God's love just takes us higher.
Thank you. Ooh, Lord, have mercy.
Don't you worry.
Don't you worry. Don't you fret.
God is with us.
God is with us.
And I will be with you always.
Even. Ooh. To the end of the world.
Come on.
And he told me to tell you, fear thou not.
Yes.
In Isaiah 41:10, fear thou not, for I am with thee. Mm. Be not dismayed. I am thy God.
Woo.
I will strengthen you. I will help you. I will uphold you with the right hand of my righteousness. God say, all they, hallelujah, that are incensed against thee shall be as nothing. They shall be confound and ashamed and be as nothing, and all they that strive against you shall perish. God said, you will seek them and not find them, and all they that contend against thee and war against thee shall come to nothing, because I, the Lord thy God, will hold you by my right hand, saying unto you, fear not, for I am with you.
Yes, Lord.
Thus saith the Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thus saith the Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
I am with you.
Yes.
Fear not. I got you. In Jesus' name.
Ooh, Lord.
Hallelujah. Thank you. Give God praise right there.
Yes, Jesus.
Tell them about my books that sold like hotcakes yesterday.
On Friday.
Born a bastard, now born again. Amen.
You can get this on the website.
On the website. The website is up there, MountCalvaryInternationalOutreach.org. We got the ball caps, the T-shirts, the pendants, the military ball caps, military pendants,
yes,
and T-shirts. They are there.
Yes.
And the books are on the website. Go in there and purchase a book and some of the items that we have listed on the website.
Born a bastard, now born again.
And then we have what? Divine Rhymes, a synopsis. Listen. There is not another book like this in all the world. That's why I know God gave it to me.
Mm-hmm.
A synopsis of every book in the Bible, scripturally,
yes,
scripturally, every book in the Bible that rhymes,
yes,
poetic. There is not another book in the world like it. You need this in your library.
Yes.
Divine Rhymes. Amen.
And we sold a lot of these Friday.
Oh, my God. When a man loves a woman. Because the world needs unconditional, not just love, unconditional love.
Yes.
We need to learn how to look beyond the faults of our mates and see their needs.
Amen.
Like God did us.
Amen.
You got faults, too. God looked beyond yours. You got to look beyond whoever your lover or your mate, your husband or your wife, look beyond their faults,
yes,
and see their needs.
Amen.
When a man loves a woman. Amen.
Then
Angel Flight. And some people died young.
Mm-hmm.
Example, Prince, Michael Jackson, John F. Kennedy, Martin Luther King, et cetera, et cetera. All the way back to slavery.
Mm-hmm.
And they looked down and said, Lord, those folk are in trouble. Let us go down and impart in them what we didn't get a chance to do while we were on planet Earth. That's why it's called angel flight.
Amen. And
wisdom is the principal thing. That's all I can tell you. You got wisdom. You got something that's more precious than
gold,
more precious than rubies.
Yes.
Wisdom is the principal thing, the power of wisdom. Then in the back of it, there's a vocabulary that will put you a cut above any conversation you're holding.
Amen.
One word, and folk will just respect you, hallelujah, for being that astute with your vocabulary.
Mm-hmm.
The power of wisdom.
Get them all on our website.
On the website.
It is listed.
Mount Calvary listed. International yes. Outreach, hallelujah.
With all the other things, our military caps,
yes,
and T-shirts, and pendants, and we just... thank God that we were able to be in a position on Friday.
Yes.
To just minister the word.
Yes.
And
many to, came to a whole auditorium came to Christ. A lot of them. Amen.
People were healed.
Confessed
then.
Their sins.
Yes.
And we just had a great time. With
great time getting out in the ministry.
Right. With Del Ronda, Big 50, who I think BET is getting ready to make a movie out of her life. And I believe that she and I are going to collaboratively do some things together. Mm-hmm. Amen. And so we're just so thankful for what God is doing in our lives today. Once again, Amen. We are bereaved. We mourn for Bishop Samuel Wilson and the loss of his wife, Lady J. Right. Okay, let's get into the word. How about that?
Amen.
Let's All get right. That. Okay, if you're there and you have your Bible, whatever method you use to read the word, we want to look at Job 14. Job. Great story. Job, this man Job. Great, 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 great life story. Very encouraging. Mm-hmm. Went through everything, but in the latter end, his latter end was better than his former end, mm-hmm. former days. Mm-hmm. But great example for all of us. But in the 14th chapter, verse 1 through 4, we find these recorded words. Man that is born of a woman is of few days and full of trouble. Mm-hmm. He cometh forth like a flower and is cut down. He fleeth also as a shadow and continueth not. And doest thou open thine eyes upon such a one and bringest me into judgment with thee? Who can bring a clean thing out of an unclean? Not one. Mm-hmm. I want to talk to you for a few minutes concerning the topic. Let's clean up our house.
Amen.
Do what you can. Mm-hmm. Hear me good. Do what you can while you can, but remember, only what you do for Christ will last. All of us in this world were born out of the womb of a woman. Mm-hmm. Consequently, after Adam sinned against God, Adam and Eve sinned against God, they fell from grace into sin, into death. So all of us, and Eve being the mother of all living, so consequently our first parents where we came from, consequently we were all born into a life of sin, danger, evil and difficulty, and that is why we all need salvation, because salvation delivers us from evil, danger, and difficulty by the blood of Jesus Christ, who knew no sin, but was made sin, that we be made the righteousness of God in him, because Jesus is the only begotten Son of God. He's the only one that was placed in the womb of a woman by the Holy Ghost, the Holy Spirit of God, and who was not born into sin. You don't have to teach little Johnny how to lie. Amen. Mama put the apple pie on the counter. Amen. Little Johnny got apple pie all around his mouth, all on his diaper. Mama said, Johnny, who ate that apple pie? Who been in my apple pie? I don't know. To teach little Johnny how to lie, because little Johnny, I don't care how cute he is, he was born into sin. And little sister, the old folk used to say, that little fast-tailed girl is now smelling herself. At some point in life, amen, she has started smelling herself. Amen. And you know what happens after that. Amen. Then we grow up into a neighborhood, some of us, into gang violence. And some rich children grow up into a home of incest. Amen. And doctor, daddy was a doctor, so they the first ones got a hold of some drugs. Amen. So, amen. Mm-hmm. And then we grow up, especially in our neighborhood, into a life of violence and police brutality. In my teens, I found out that my first love, my high school girlfriend, came out of the motel with my best friend, amen. I was scheduled for college. Some of you young ladies were scheduled for college, but you got pregnant. And then little brother got caught up wrong, and then sometimes innocent, innocent, didn't do anything at all, but still went to prison. Then we grow up and find out there is something in our body that requires surgery, and now we're on a lifetime medication. Mm. Some of us went to school and got our dream job in corporate America, only to be told that we're going in another direction and we do not need your services anymore. And ultimately, we come to a place where, amen, people assemble together for a home going because we pass, amen, from the earth. Amen. Born of a few days and full of trouble. As much money and prestige and that Michael Jackson had, few days, accused him of being a pedophile, full of trouble. Prince, amen, died on the elevator in his home, a few days, full of trouble. John F. Kennedy, the president of the United States, amen, assassinated on a street in Dallas, Texas, in a convertible Lincoln, amen, my dream car, few days, but full of trouble, amen. Dr. Martin Luther King, amen, just to name a few, died, what 30-some years old? Few days, but assassinated in Memphis, Tennessee, and full of trouble. Mm. Beat up, spit on, locked up in a Birmingham jail. Few days, but full of trouble. Old Blue Eyes said it at best. That's life. That's what the people say. Amen. That's what the people say. Flying high in April, but shot down in May. And that's a fact, Jack. And that's the truth, Ruth. Not casting any aspersions on anyone, but it doesn't matter how good our parents were to us. I don't care how rich you are. Your children, some of the richest children in the world, are in some of the biggest mess in the world. Amen. Some of the richest people in the world are some of the biggest crooks in the world. Amen. So it doesn't matter how good your parents are to you, what neighborhood you were born in. Amen. How much money you got, how much they nurtured you, sent you to the best college. Amen. There was a scandal, I think, last year where the folk paid millions to get their children in college. Mm-hmm. Amen. Corrupt. Amen. And spoiled us. I don't care how spoiled you are. Trouble will come. When I would do good, evil is always present. Christ warned us in the scripture. Amen. John 16 and 33. These things I have spoken unto you, that in me you might have peace. In the world, not if I woulda, shoulda, coulda. In the world, you shall have tribulation. Mm. But be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. What does that mean? That means when you are in Christ and he's in you and he overcame death, hell, and the grave, you got to overcome the troubles of this world because God will put a peace in you that passeth all understanding, yes, a joy, unspeakable joy, and he will be with you and in you with his power, and no evil shall befall you, and no plague can come to your dwelling. No. Now, the remedy here, and I'm not talking about remedy, VSOP, but the remedy here is in Matthew 11, 28. Come unto me, Jesus says, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. If you're feeling defeated, deleted, and depleted, Jesus said, depressed, oppressed, sick and tired of being sick and tired, he said, come, just come unto me. Hook up with me. My yoke is easy and my burden is light. Have you ever seen the old black and white movies where the two oxen are pulling a wagon down the street and they have this collar around their neck and they're yoked up with each other? Well, that's all Jesus is saying. Yoke up with me. And I'll pull the wagon. Mm. Hallelujah. Now, who would serve a God like that?
Come on now.
Please allow me to insert a little bit of my testimony in here right now. There was a man in the Bible, blind from his mother's womb, and Jesus healed him. And the unbelievers, amen, taunted the man, you know, about what authority were you healed? How you get your sight? What happened to you? Who did it? He said, well, I don't know who did it. I don't know how he did it. All I know is I once was blind, but now I see. See, I had accepted Christ in Bastrop, Texas, FCI, before I had been transformed. I was transferred. I had been transformed, mind you, before I was transferred to Milan FCI. Mm-hmm. Amen. Prison facing 10 years. Amen. Short of the long story, I don't know how I was had peace behind a barbed wire fence facing 10 years. I don't know how I was at peace with a roll of quarters in my pocket when I was used to counting duffel bags and grocery bags and shoe bags full of money. I don't know how I was content sleeping on a bunk bed when I was used to sleeping on a customized king-size gold-plated bed on silk and satin sheets. I don't know how I was satisfied with some prison khakis on when I was used to shopping at Bijan in Beverly Hills and tailored by Arthur Williams in California. I don't know why or how or why I was comfortable in a pair of sneakers in prison when I was used to wearing handmade baby calf skin shoes and the belly of the crocodile from City Slicker Shoe Store. I went in slanging with the mind, amen, to keep slanging and came out singing, oh, the blood of Jesus. I don't know. I don't know how he did it. I don't know how I was apprehended by somebody that I couldn't even comprehend. All I know is I once was blind, but now I see. Hallelujah. The peace, the joy, the satisfaction I look for in the world, self-medicating with drugs and partying, amen, in different areas, amen, with all kinds of people, amen, living large, buying new Cadillacs off the showroom floor. I went to eat at Tavern on the Green because they said Michael Jackson had started his victory tour up in there. I mean, I was just all the championship fights and, amen, the Kentucky Derby and traveling when I got ready and shopping till I dropped, amen, living a big life, but never finding the void that I had in my life. Mm-hmm. Then to seal the deal, about 13 years ago, God stepped in and gave me the most beautiful woman in the world. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I found every woman in one woman. Hallelujah. Yeah. My wife, the Empress Vicki Lockhart Calvert. I found it all in Christ Jesus, and it has lasted until this day. Have I sinned? Yes. Have I been perfect? No. But what I have, the world did not give it to me, and the world can't take it away. The devil cannot steal my joy because he don't know where God put it. Yeah. As I close, I'm saddened about the disqualification of Sha'Carri Richardson. They took millions of dollars from her in endorsements because she smoked some weed after her mother had passed. Amen. Everybody needs some kind of comfort or some kind of, sometimes they self-medicate when a tragedy happens in their lives. I'm saddened about that. But her gift, Sha'Carri Richardson's ability, her strength to bounce back, they can't take it away because it was given to her by God. And God blessed her still because Nike is still standing by her. Amen. Thank God. Thank God. You know, that was a young man in the Bible, the son of a widow, and the only hope back in those days, amen, a widow woman had to secure her life was that a man was in her house, but her son had died. Scripture says, on the way to the graveyard, Jesus read the situation that the woman's son had died. She had no hope in the world without a son, a man in the house. So Jesus touched the bier, the casket, and said, I say unto thee, arise. The young man came back to life. And I want to say to all of you, amen, that what death has taken away in your life, amen, what the unjust system has taken away, amen, what the devil has destroyed in your life, your dreams have not come when you wanted them to. All the things that you thought was dead in your life, maybe that property that you want, that dream house, that relationship, amen, that entrepreneurship, amen, that a business that you wanted to set up, maybe it's taken a long time to come and it seemed like it is dead. But I say unto you that Jesus came down the staircase of heaven, yes, amen, through 42 generations, born in Bethlehem, hid in Egypt, raised up in Nazareth, tempted in the wilderness, baptized in Jordan, performed miracles by the roadside, When people got hungry, he supernaturally multiplied, healed multitudes with no vaccine and made no charge for his service. Ooh. He suffered, amen, was tortured, crucified, died for you and me, but rose from the dead the third day according to the scriptures. Jesus Christ was only 33 and a half years old. Amen. They taunted him on every hand. They doubted him on every hand. They kicked him around on every hand. They beat him down on every hand. They stuck him in the side with a 7-foot spear. That crown of thorns crushed down on his head. At the place of execution, they nailed his hands to the path of alarm, piercing the median nerves in his hand, sending lightning-like shock-wake pains all through his body. Then they pierced his feet to the stipes, piercing the intermetal tarsal space of his feet, sending pain all through Jesus' body. Oh, y'all better come on, go with me. Hallelujah. Only 33 years old. Amen. He could have died from exhaustion, asphyxia. Amen. But he was wounded for our transgression, bruised for our iniquity. And the chastisement of our peace was upon him. And with his stripes, we got the healing. Jesus, born a few days, 33 and a half years, but full of trouble. But thank God he rose from the dead. And Jesus is not just some way or a way of retrieving all you have lost, all you thought was dead and more, but he is the way, the truth, and the life. At the graveside of Lazarus, his friend, when Jesus was questioned by Mary concerning his resurrection power, hey, if you had been here, my brother had not died. Jesus deliberately tarried 4 days before arriving at Lazarus' grave, intimating it doesn't matter how long one has been dead in the grave. It doesn't matter how long that situation has been dead in your life. It doesn't matter how long your dreams have been dead in your life. It doesn't matter how long your children have gone crazy and your mate have been acting a fool. Amen. He's still able to resurrect your situation. He emphatically and definitively stated these most comforting words in John 11, 26, 25 and 26. I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. Believest thou this? Do all you can while you can, but believe thou this, that only what you do for Christ will last. So let's clean up our house. The songwriter picked it up. When we've been there 10,000 years, bright shining as the sun, in the sun-kissed region of unclouded days, where love is in the menu every day of your life.
My Lord.
When we've been there 10,000 years, bright shining as the sun. We've no less days, which means we got 10,000 more coming, and then 100,000, then 1,000,000, 1,000,000,000,000, 1,000,000,000,000 years to live in eternity because of the resurrection and the life that we believe on in Jesus Christ.
Thank you, Lord.
Now you got 2 ears for information. You got 2 eyes for observation. You got 2 nostrils for inhalation. You got 2 lips for communication. You got 2 hands for salutation. You got 2 feet for transportation. But you got 1 life. 1 life to do all you can while you can, but only what you do for Christ will last. Let's clean up our house, because there is therefore now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. For the life of the law, the Spirit of love in Christ has made us free. We're free from sin and death. For what the law could not do, God sent his son and the likeness of sinful flesh, and for sin, condemn sin in the flesh, that the righteousness, Lord, have of the law be fulfilled in me and you, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. Pray with me. Pray with me that the resurrection and the life will come into your life and release you from danger, evil, and difficulty. Let's clean up our house right now. Say, dear God, I have sinned. I have done evil in your sight. My days are few and full of trouble. But Lord, deliver me from those things that are holding me down. Because I believe you rose from the dead. So now, Lord, rise up in me and forgive me of everything I've done wrong. Help me to bury my old self, because my old self stinks. Anything stinks need to be buried. But Lord, come into my life and rise up in me.
Yes, Lord.
Please, Jesus, rise up in me.
Hallelujah.
And give me a new life.
Thank you, Jesus.
Because I believe that you are the resurrection and the life. I believe you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. In Jesus' mighty name. We believe if you prayed that prayer to be absent from the body, you will be present with the Lord to live with him forever. He that believeth shall have life. He that believeth not can even see life, for the wrath of God abideth upon him. God never asked us to intellectually diagnose this thing. While people are trying to figure this out, God has already worked it out through the cross of his Son, Jesus Christ. Just believe in Jesus' mighty name. The Lord is our keeper. The Lord is our shade. The Lord, upon thy right hand, the sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve thy soul, hence now and even forevermore. Nor the moon by night. We love you. God bless you, man. God bless you. God be with you. Hallelujah. We love you. And we've been a blessing to you. We got a Cash App thing up on the screen there. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. My help. My help. If you don't send a dime, my help, our help come from the Lord. From the Lord. But when you give, God will give back to you good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over. He'll have men to give to your bosom. Sometimes not monetarily, but in good health. He'll bless you for helping us to help others in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. We love you, man. Peace. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you real good. Be safe. Be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Jesus. Oh, my help. See you next week. Same time, 12 to 1. Amen. Eastern Standard Time. I'm Elder Alfred L. Calvin. This is the Empress Vicki Lockhart Calvin. And we love you dearly in Jesus' mighty name.